Garner support from all the stakeholders that were involved in this process. He will arrive December 20th, and she hopes will get a warm reception from the community. In Dayton, Mike Campbell, News Center 7.
And now, your Storm Center 7 forecast with Chief Meteorologist McCall Brightags.
And I know what's going on Live.47 Radar as it was earlier today, and we're not going to complain about that.
No, we are not. We had a good amount of rain the past couple of days, so we're getting some time to dry out before I see more rain back in the forecast. But while we dry out, we're also looking at some cooler than average temperatures and perhaps the first day where we wake up in the 30s in months. I'll tell you which morning that is in a few moments. A look at Live Doppler 7 right now. You can see as we scan the skies, there's nothing falling from it, according to radar. Now, that said, there is some cloud cover still hanging out overhead. So there might be a few leftover sprinkles, maybe to the south and southeast of Dayton. Other than that, the cloud cover is now beginning to break apart, and by early tomorrow morning, we should have a decent amount of clearing to start the day. And those areas that still have some cloud cover early will give way to a mostly sunny sky as we head toward the afternoon. Although it's going to feel quite chilly, not only because of the temperature, but because of the wind. We had some gusty winds out there today, and they're still pretty breezy. Still some winds gusting up close to 20 to 25 miles per hour. Winds will be breezy through the night, and by daybreak tomorrow, still a wind out of the north and northwest could be anywhere between 15 to 20 miles per hour. We'll keep the breezy weather around through your day on Tuesday, and the wind flows still primarily out of the north and northwest. As we get into tomorrow night, those winds will subside, but the timing with clear skies and calm winds, well, that's what's going to pull our temperatures way down as we wake up early on Wednesday, expected to be in the 30s. You'll see that cold air funneling in from the north over the next 24 to 36 hours. It is somewhat brief because we do see that wind shift and some milder temperatures back in the forecast for the end of the week. So here's our morning low trend. So I just want to point this out so you have an idea of what we're looking ahead to. Typically, we should have a low around 43 degrees. Tonight, we're expected to be around 45 for an overnight low, and that's because we do have the cloud cover hanging out overhead. If it wasn't there, we'd be dropping much further than that. Wednesday morning, 38 in the city of Dayton. Outside the city, in those middle to perhaps low 30s, and may see our first areas of patchy frost for the season, and then 48 degrees for your morning low on Thursday. That had me questioning, when do we typically have our first freeze in Dayton? Well, on average, it's around October 25th, which we are coming up on real quick here. But the latest we've gone in the season before dropping to 32 degrees or colder was at the end of November. I don't think we're going to make it that far before we see our 32-degree temperature, at least not based on the trends that we're seeing in the next few weeks. Your bus stop forecast for tomorrow, 47 degrees, a chilly start for the kids when they walk out the door. They'll need the jacket in the morning and through the afternoon with a high near the mid-50s and breezy conditions. It will likely feel like those upper 40s to low 50s throughout much of the day tomorrow. Other than that, though, the weather will be all right for Tuesday and Wednesday after school sports. Just dress appropriately for those cooler temperatures. Thursday, though, rain returns, and it's going to be with us through the end of the week. Here's future cast for Thursday. We wake up in the morning dry. By the afternoon, those showers move in, and the rain will be with us not only through Thursday afternoon and evening, but throughout the day Friday. There's 7 a.m. Friday through the day Friday, and then tapering as we get into the start of Saturday. We'll likely see the sunshine returning, perhaps by Saturday afternoon, a better chance for some sunshine back in the forecast on Sunday. So here's that five-day forecast for you. A cool day for us tomorrow, but we get the sunshine back. We're back to about 58 degrees on Wednesday. Rain showers return. We're near those upper 50s to low 60s into the start of the weekend.
Thank you, McCall. Yellow Springs comedian Dave Chappelle responded to the controversy surrounding his newest comedy special, The